To connect to a remote Git repository, we are going to use the secure and reliable SSH connection. You can also use HTTPS on a lot of sites, but this tends to create problems in a lot of cases. Your best bet for smooth operation is therefore SSH. To use SSH, we have to use a public-private key pair. This is a unique set of files used to encrypt the connection between you and the server. If you're on Mac, skip ahead to 2 minutes 15. On Windows, we will use PuTTY, PuTTY, to generate and load our SSH key. Install PuTTY using all the default options. Then open your Start menu and type or look for PuTTY Gen. Start PuTTY Gen, the PuTTY key generator. Press Generate and move your mouse over the blank area until the progress bar is filled. Now a key has been generated. If you want to, change the key comment to something describing the computer you're working on. Also, set a passphrase, unless you're absolutely positive that your computer is very well secured and nobody will ever be able to access your files. This is because just having the key file that you generate will enable anyone to access and change your repository via SSH, if you don't set a passphrase. Click Save Public Key, and Save Private Key, and save both keys in some location you can remember. Now we have to copy the public key shown in the upper panel to our repository host. Beware that the key is longer than what you see in the panel, so you have to select all first. Then copy the contents of the key to the clipboard. I'll now explain generating a key pair for Mac users. You can skip to 3 minutes 15 if you're on Windows. On Mac, open the terminal application found under Utilities and enter ssh-keygen. Your Mac will ask you where to save your keys. You should leave this at the default by simply pressing Enter. Set a passphrase, unless you're absolutely positive that your computer is very well secured and nobody will ever be able to access your files. This is because just having the key file that you generate will enable anyone to access and change your repository via SSH, if you don't set a passphrase. Your keys have been saved to disk. Now you have to copy the public key so you can paste it on your server. To show the key, type CAT, a space, and the name of the public key saved above. So for the default location, that's .ssh/id_rsa.pub. Now you can select the key contents and copy them. Now, whether you're on Mac or on Windows, you will have your public key on your clipboard. You can paste your key on the SSH keys page of your repository host. I'll show where that is for Bitbucket, GitLab, and firstly, GitHub. Click on your portrait icon in the top right and go to Settings. In the menu to the left, there is an option for SSH keys. There you can click New SSH key, paste your key into the key text area, give the key a name, and press Add SSH key to finish. Similarly, on GitLab, press Profile Settings, or in older versions, the little man icon at the top right menu, and SSH keys, Add SSH key, paste your key into the key text area, and click Add key to finish. And the same goes for Bitbucket. Click on your portrait icon in the top right and Bitbucket settings. In the menu to the left, press SSH keys, then press Add key. Paste your key into the key text area. Give the key a name and press Add key to finish. Now that you've added your SSH key, SourceTree will be able to connect to your repositories. I'll first show you how to create a repository from the one that you made on disk in the previous video. This includes a number of steps that occur when you clone an existing repository, so I advise to try this once. You can simply delete the repository from the server after finishing this tutorial. Create a project on the site of your choice. I will use GitLab as an example because GitLab offers private repositories for free. The way to create a project differs between sites, but I think you should be able to manage that on your own. After creating a project, you will see the address of its repository. Press the copy button or just copy the address and go back to SourceTree. Open the repository menu and repository settings. Press the add button to add a remote repository. Type a name for the remote, or in most cases simply check default remote to use the default name origin. Then paste the address of the repository in the url/path field. Press OK and you have added the remote. You'll see the remote appearing under remotes. Now you can upload your changes to the remote. This is called pushing your commits. Press the push button. Because we're creating a new repository, we also have to check the master branch. This branch of commits will be pushed to the server when we click OK. Since this is the first time we're connecting to the server, SSH needs you to confirm that you're connecting to the server you think you're connecting to. This is done using a fingerprint, a sequence of 32 hexadecimal characters that uniquely confirms the identity of the server. You will see the server's fingerprint, which you can check with the one provided on the repository website if you like. You can also simply assume that nobody is trying to break into your connection at this time, and just accept the key, so that from now on your system will check for you if it has not changed. In short, or if you don't care very much about security anyway, just press yes. Now you will have to load your own SSH key to identify yourself to the server. On Mac, you only have to provide your passphrase if you save the key at the default location. In Windows, you can do this using the PuTTY SSH key agent, Pagent. SourceTree can launch Pagent for you, so answer yes and yes once again to load your key. Browse to your key and enter the passphrase. Now that you've loaded your key into Pagent, you can press retry and your connection is made. SourceTree will finish the push task and you will see a new label appearing in the line of the last commit saying origin/master. This indicates that that commit has been successfully pushed to the remote called origin. When you are not the person creating a project but just want to start working along on an existing project, you have to make a local copy of the repository. This is called cloning. On the project page, you will see the address of its repository. Press the copy button or just copy the address and go back to SourceTree. Press the clone/new button and paste the repository address into the sourcepath/url field. SourceTree will start checking the connection to the repository. At this point, if you haven't connected to the server before, you will have to accept the server's key and probably load your own SSH key, like I've shown a little while back when starting a repository. Choose an empty folder to clone the project into and press clone to clone the repository. Depending on the project you cloned, some branches will be available on the server, but by default, Git will just check out the master branch for you after cloning. Here you see I've cloned the repository that I created earlier, with its commits and latest changes. Now I'm going to clone the repository a second time, in a different folder. We'll pretend that this first one was cloned by a collaborator called Anne, and now I'll pretend to be Ben and clone it into my folder. Here, I've opened both folders, Anne's to the left and Ben's to the right. You can see, as expected, that both have the same contents. Let's have Anne make some changes. We'll open Anne's copy of text file 1 and have her add a line to it. Save the file and go back to SourceTree. Stage and commit the changes as before. You see that the changes are committed to a local master branch, showing to be one ahead of its remote counterpart, origin/master. You'll also see a number 1 appearing on the push button, indicating that there is one commit available to push to the remote. To do this, press push and then OK. Now you see that the server has all ANS commits. The origin/master label is shown at the last commit, the local master branch does not show one ahead anymore, and the push button also has no label. So let's have Ben get ANS changes. Switching to Ben's copy of the repository, you see that he still only has the first 2 commits. To fetch and apply the latest changes on the server, Ben can press pull and then OK to pull the master branch. Now Ben's copy is up to date with the latest changes from the server. Here you see that Ben's copy of text file 1 now has ANS line in it. Now you've seen how to have one person push and another pull changes from a repository. In the next part, I'll show you what happens when both collaborators want to make changes to the files at the same time.